Your boy Reason from the Legacy here, and today I'm just gonna do a little quick cook up with like a Six Black kind of Bryson Tiller type track. I'm not really gonna be doing that much talking unless I really need to, unless I'm like explaining anything. So just sit back, enjoy, let's start. So what I'm doing right now is basically just trying to get my sample to be at a certain tempo and time stretched out. And what I just did was basically just, there was like a weird clicking in the beginning of it. And I could have EQ'd it out, but I decided to just kind of cut it and take it out. Now the sample sounds like this. Sounds like my kick, my hi-hat. Oh, I've got another kick apparently. Forgot I renamed him. Hi-hat, another hi-hat, open hat, snare, a lot of snare. So of course, as I go along making the beat, I'm gonna add more, but for now that's what I'm gonna go with. So let's try to lay down some drums and see if it works. So let's get into it. Okay, so what I just did here was to kind of, so you see how the long gated notes are over here and the shorter notes, a hotkey to make them all the same is Shift D, and it automatically will just make them all the same note, for those that didn't know how to do it in FL Studio. So I'm gonna do that, and then I'm gonna Control C, Control V to copy it. Gonna lower the volume on both of them to where I want it to be. Read the velocity. And a lot of like a lot of Black type beats and like Bryson Tiller type beats are pretty, like the drums are pretty like simple and aired out, just to kind of give the artist more room. As I said, or as I'm gonna say, this is like my take on it. Of course, I'm not gonna be able to make it exact, so you know, bear with me. And then another trick I like to do with like my R&B beats is to kind of like always have one, we call it two to the floor in FL Studio. I'm not really sure what other DAWs call it. I think it might be the same thing. But and then I lower, so I'll do that, then I'll take every other one and lower the velocity of it to kind of give it this effect. Play with the beat. Then for my open hi-hat, this is kind of, it's going to be like a free ball kind of thing. Okay. Okay, make sure it's not panned. Probably gonna change the sound because it has a lot of like high end, or I could just EQ it out. I'll see. Take that out. So what I just added there was kind of like an intro. So this part's gonna be the intro, and then I'm gonna have like the hi-hats and the open hat kind of playing in the background. So kind of like this. But what I'm gonna do is probably add some reverb to this, and then I'm gonna cut off some of the out. By cutting off some of the out, it basically cuts off the end tail frequency of the sound itself. See how a stomp would. Yeah, that does not sound good. A little shaker just for like a, to kind of get some groove to it. Change this little rim shot here with a sound from take this, and I already pretty much tuned the 808 prior to starting the video because I didn't really want to go into that. But a quick step to how I do it is I literally just go, oh, not that. I go click Edison, take the sample. Go back into here and yeah, that's the sample name, guys. I guess I can't really hide that. And then you go here. So a lot of people would assume that the first little hash mark is basically the key for the 808, which is wrong. You normally want to take the longer tail. Because that's basically where more of the lower frequencies hit, and then as you can see back over here, kind of peaks back up. So I'm just gonna leave it at middle C. Then I'm gonna put a note here and click Alt L on my keyboard to elongate them, and then now I can basically do whatever I want with it. So that's kind of like a little, food for thought for those who didn't know how to do that. And the number that represents doesn't really matter because no matter what, if I even put it at C2, where's C2 right here, and then I go back to the actual thing and I put it on C2, it's still going to be the same, it's still going to be in key. But for the purpose of this video, I'll just put it at what this sample showed, and then go from there. Oh, took off the tom. And then what I want to do here is kind of have like a... Whenever you're doing something like this, always make sure that it's in that key. And right now I'm doing the C major chord, I believe. Yeah. Not really, I'm trying to get better at it, but it should be C major. And then, so when I play it back, it's like this. Few slide notes, change the panning of them, make that go down, make that go up. And now what I'm going to do is control up to kind of make them go in a higher octave. Do the same thing for this, control up. So now, all together with the beat, with the actual sample tone of this. Start to kind of add like just some effect that I normally like to add. One of them, being this. this one, and then if that one doesn't work, I'll use my other one instead. And then I go another way, just to kind of line them up. Up, bring it all the way up, and then normalize it and reverse it that way it gives me this. Then we're gonna drag, zoom in, and then chop any excess that we don't need. And then mixer, I'm gonna lower this a bit, take this off. And then I know one thing that I've kind of seen with like R&B beats as of now is they like to kind of like low pass filter everything. So we're gonna see if that works. Lower this a bit, and then create automation clip. And then right when the phaser is hitting is where I'm gonna start to lower it. And the reason why I'm leaving a little gap right there is because I like to kind of have like a stop and go kind of thing in my R&B beats. And I'm going to add a little effect right there. Effects that's going to kind of bring the beat back in, if I can find it. Alright, here we go. Thank you. So that's pretty much it, or at least all I want to add for right now. Let me see if I can add a little bit more. That's what I want to add. Okay. So forgot. Right. Now I'm gonna turn everything on, and then I'm gonna go up to here, split by channel, go to here. And then take everything and put it in the mixer. And then lower this to like maybe 15 might be good. Now I'm just gonna layer out how I want the beat to be. So we might have to make some slight changes to how we do this, because now I kind of want to have a different variation. Pull that back up. Thank you. All right, so of course, you know, the beat's not mixed or mastered yet, so it's not really gonna sound as good. I'm probably gonna end up doing that off camera, and I'll probably end up changing the tom right here out with a different beat. But I'm just gonna add my tag in real quick, do some leveling, and then play the beat off, and I'll be the video. So yeah, just hang on out with me for a little bit longer, and we're almost done.
What's
then I'm gonna go to my mixer presets, and I already always have like a preset ready for my tag. Go here, lower that a bit. Take all of these, and now we're gonna do some leveling just so everything kind of sounds, you know, not fighting for attention or fighting for room. I'm gonna mix it in mono, that way I can hear it better. I'll probably do some more leveling, but this is just kind of like a rough, you know, gesture of what I got. Me lock my tag in so I can put it where I need it to be. Alright, so I'm gonna play the beat out twice and then wrap it up. So yeah, here's the beat. Thank you.
what's your reason?
So that's all I'm going to do for today, this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I'm going to put a beat back. It's been your boy Reason. Signing out.
What's your reason? We'll be right back. what's your reason?